In this special build edition of the AI show, we'll get to hear from Tracy Chen, Senior Program Manager on the Azure Machine Learning team. Sometimes when we're doing batch inference, there's just a lot of stuff to do. At the same time, Tracy will introduce you to something called Parallel Run Step and how it makes it easier to do that kind of workload. Make sure you tune in.
Hello, everyone. I'm Tracy Chen, Senior Program Manager with Azure Machine Learning. Today, I'm going to introduce you how to run batch inference using Azure Machine Learning Pipeline Parallel Run Step. First, let's talk about what is batch inference. Actually, batch inference is everywhere. Cybersecurity team analyze hundreds of thousands of emails for security threats every hour. A retailer has millions of customers and want to segment the customers for various marketing campaigns. Grocery want to forecast sales for thousands of products for each store. Banks with thousands of ATM machines and want to predict money refill amount and frequency. These are all batch inference scenarios. They are really large workloads. You are dealing with terabytes of data, and you don't expect to get instant responses. You can wait for hours or days to check the results. We know the challenge to run batch inference. It's not easy to scale up and out with such large workloads. You need to partition the data, structured or unstructured, terabytes of data. You need to distribute and coordinate the workloads across a cluster of machines and consolidate the results returned from each machine. You need to manage the machine cluster. You need to handle failures and errors. We have the solution to help you. It's the Parallel Run Step. It's fully composable in Azure Machine Learning pipelines. It's a managed stack with out-of-the-box parallelism. You don't need to worry about how to split the data, how to distribute workloads, and how to manage the cluster. Just tell us where is the data, what model you're going to use, how many machines you want to run the job. We do all the heavy lifting for you. If a task failed, we retry it. If a machine dies, we retry it on another one. By default, we retry 3 times, and you can also set the retry count. If the job partially failed, we still return the partial successful results. Let me show you an example how to use Parallel Run Step to do batch inference. In this notebook, I'm using a pre-trained digital identification model and run batch inference on MNIST test dataset. First, you need to prepare some resources. Connect to any workspace, create a new one, or connect to any existing one. You will also need a computer cluster. Here I'm using a CPU cluster. Then you need to configure the inputs and outputs. Parallel Run Step accepts Azure Machine Learning dataset as inputs. As in this demo, we're using images, so I'm creating a file dataset. We're putting the MNIST test images on a public data store. So I'm creating a data store and connecting to that public blob. And then create a file dataset from this data store. So in order to reduce the pipeline, I'm creating a pipeline parameter for this input dataset so that when I resubmit the pipeline, I can pass in a brand new dataset. Oh, I will show you how to use this parameter later. Now you have the inputs ready and you need to create output to store the inference output. I'm using a pipeline data for the output. This section is just to prepare the model. Just download the model and register it with your workspace. Now let's build the Parallel Run Step pipeline. It's important to provide the inference script. We call it the entry script. Because you need to split the data into multiple mini batches, the entry script tells us how to do inference on each mini batch. So there are 2 major functions within the entry script. One is the init function. The init function is used to do common preparation such as load the model into a global object. The run function tells us how to do inference on the mini batch. So it's a very small for loop to iterate on each of the mini batch and get the prediction. You also need to specify the environment, like the kernel environment, to run your inference script. Parallel run config is a major config you're going to use to wrap up all the configurations for parallel run step. There are a few very important parameters. Mini batch size defines the size of the mini batch. It'll be passed to run method in entry script. It's a demo M using file dataset, so it means the number of files per each mini batch. Error threshold defines the number of failures the entire job can tolerate. For file dataset, it's the number of file failures, and for tabular, it's the number of record failures. If the count goes beyond this threshold, the entire job will be aborted. You can auto set it to -1 if you want to ignore all failures. Output action defines how to organize output. You can choose between two values, summary only, or like append rows that I'm using here. Append row means you will combine all the outputs into one output file. And I'm also using the append row file name to customize the output file. So this mlist-output.txt will contain all the inference results for the entire job. Process count per node and the node count can be used to fine-tune the computer resource. There are also several other configurations that I'm not using here, like login, timeout setting, and retry count. All these configures can be defined as pipeline parameter, so that when you resubmit runs, you can fine-tune these parameters. Now you have everything you need to create a parallel run step. Pass in the config, the inputs, and the output. That's it, you're all set. Submit the pipeline run now, check the results later. As I've defined the input dataset and several configs as pipeline parameter, I can now submit the pipeline run with a brand new data input and also fine-tune those parameters. Go to the Azure portal to check the results. Here are several runs I submitted earlier. Go to the run detail page to get the run ID, and go to your configured output location to get the results. Here are a few links for resources. If you have any questions regarding batch inference or parallel run step, reach out to me or my team. Thank you.